the determination to get better at that matchup. So next time we do the Mango Fan tournament, you kick Switch's ass. It's fine. We'll seed it. We'll make sure that you go against Switch again. but no, that was a good showing, honestly. Like I said, Switch is obviously, you know, renowned for being a very good player, both in PM and melee. So not a bad showing. Not too bad at all. So let's see what happened while all that was going on. Treos against Jack, Nino against Mutroid, Sleep, Hamburger, Mad. Yeah, we're well into this winner's bracket tree right now. Who we got?
Okay, so we've got Alex versus Dawson, who is a Puff player.
And Alex, no, Alex, I assume not like
me, is a Fox.
Okay. Is this game?
I think this is a hand warm.
Okay.
God, I hope this isn't game. We are closing out and switching to a different game if this is game.
Yeah, no, it's definitely not. Thank God. Yeah, it's not Alex 19, is it? It's just a tag of Alex, is it?
I think so, yeah.
Okay. Because that would be nuts.
I wish.
Where is that? I need to message Alex. I haven't spoken to Alex in forever.
He did a stream a couple months ago, and I went and said, hey.
Yeah, he's like gone off the map. It's good, though, honestly, sometimes. In quarantine, just going off the map, enjoying yourself. Love to see it. I think for the first part of quarantine, I just went off the grid. I just drank wine all day. Watched my little murder documentaries. It was beautiful. Ready, go. All right, so this also might not be game. Yes, it is. the little cancels on the platform. That was cute. This Puff is practicing their cancels.
Extreme tech skill.
No, we're not just out here back airing. We're practicing our platform cancels now. All right, game one. Alex versus Dawson. Dawson's the Puff. Alex is the Fox. Let's go. Nakey Puff, might I add. Maybe one of my favorite skins.
Absolutely. Who needs those? Who needs those clothes?
Damn, Alex's movement's really, really nice. Very, very nice. Very fast.
Yeah.
Oh! Wow. Damn, that's amazing.
That's a good sign when you jab and it looks very intentional to like follow where Puff ended up after the jab. Sometimes you'll see people like jab and the jab will miss and then they'll still go for the up smash and then get punished.
Yeah. Oh, getting punished there. Alex is really good at, it seems like, punishing Puff, so I guess maybe he knows the matchup or studied it a little bit for sure.
Wow.
Oh, went so low! Oh my lord, no, that'll be it for the Puff for sure. Oh!
No?
Like? The last jump. Oh! Okay. Alex just kind of just taking the sender, pushing Puff out of it.
I love it. This is my new favorite. Alex is winning the whole thing.
I keep showing up here, you know, someone's going to be able to stay in the pocket with me and stay in there and fight with me. And I hope it's this Saturday night. Do I think so? I do not. I'm in some shape here at the minute, and I tell you this now, I am coming to put on a masterpiece.
Fucking awesome, me too.
I'm the lawyer, I got the Louisiana hot sauce. I look forward to bringing the hot sauce in the foyer tomorrow. Let's go. Thank you so much for the support, everyone. I'm so excited to be back. You're in for a treat tomorrow night, all right? Let's go.
There he is, folks. There's only one, Conor McGregor. And we step over here.
I'm waiting on that whiskey.
And, of course, talk to Dustin Poirier, who is waiting on his bottle of Proper 12 Irish whiskey. Any final thoughts before another big one? You've had 10 UFC lightweight wins since that first meeting.
My whole career has aligned me for tomorrow night, and I'm here to be victorious and get my hand raised by any means necessary. I'm leaving it all out there. Let's go.
Get some sleep. We'll see you tomorrow. There he is, Dustin Poirier and Conor McGregor.
You can have anything you want if you want it badly enough. You can be anything you want to be. Do anything you set out to accomplish if you hold to that desire with singleness of purpose.
The first UFC pay.
Very uncharacteristically, well, I shouldn't say that because he did the same thing with Donald Cerrone. He's been very nice this week, you know. Him and what, Dustin.
Well, I was going to say, what did you, when you saw, did you see the weigh-in between them?
Yeah, I did. Yeah. So, and I saw some little bits of the press conference as well.
What was Conor saying to Dustin? Because I couldn't pick it up.
I forget the words verbatim, but it was nothing. It was like, me and you, we both know what it's like to be in there. It's on type thing. There was no particular trash talk or shit talk. Conor looks very focused, as does Dustin. You know, the thing is, when you fight like that, when you've shared the octagon, which you did in the past, you know, then you kind of, there's a level of respect there for the most part. You know, sometimes you end up hating the guy, but generally you don't. And they were going to fight, and then Connor's made a contribution to his foundation to give a big charitable donation. So it's respectful, and it's all just business, you know, coming into this one. And I think Connor's trying to lull him into a false sense of security. Connor's a fast starter. Dustin isn't necessarily a slow starter, but he's not a fast starter like Connor, you know. So Connor's just playing nice. Yeah, we're all pals here. We're just going to go out there, have a little sparring match. And as soon as it says start, boom, when the referee's like, bring it on, come on, or let's get it on, whatever it is. He's just going to attack him and try and catch him off guard. Well, you're smart to do that, you know. If I was putting a bet on this, I'd put my money on Conor for sure. Obviously, they fought in the past. It took about 90 seconds for Conor to get him out of there. It was one-way traffic. Conor wasn't...
versus Fox. Ready? Go!
Two, 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 two
Versus Fox. Ready? Go! Choose your character.